through the North Salt Highway to the north will surely notice the popular Bukit Merah Lake Town on the right. Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve is on the western side of the lake, while on the left is part of more than 20,000 hectares of paddy fields in Krian District. To understand the importance of Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve, we need to understand the whole ecosystem of Krian District. Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve is a water catchment area where all the water flows into Tasik Bukit Merah. Tasik Bukit Merah supposedly acts as a buffer to supply water to paddy fields and domestic consumptions, preventing floods during rainy season and to ensure enough supply of water during dry seasons. For almost 100 years since Bukit Merah Dam was built, the ecological balance was in almost perfect harmony, but for the last 10 years, this ecological balance was disturbed. In 1913, a total of 10,170 hectares had been gazetted as Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve. But the latest statistics released by Forestry Department showed that only 4,446 hectares left. More than half of Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve had been de-gazetted, developed, and now caused a great impact on water supply to Tasik Bukit Merah. Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve is the only large black water swamp found in northern Malaysia. It is called black water swamp because the water is blackish. This is due to high carbon content found in peat, which was formed through decomposition. Humic acid found in peats will be absorbed by passing water and thus producing black but clear water, which creates a perfect environment for aquarium fishes, especially arowana. There are four main rivers crisscrossing Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve and all ended up in Tasik Bukit Merah. A study conducted by USM in 1999, 139 species of plants from 54 families and 42 species of fish from 19 families. Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve is around 1,000 years old. It is still young if you were to compare to Kalimantan wetlands, which is estimated at 10,000 years old. The age of peat swamp can be measured by its thickness. 1 meter of peat is laid down every 500 years. A lot of people don't realize the importance of peat swamp. They act as filters, absorbing nutrients and removing toxins. They absorb excessive water and slowly releasing it, thus also preventing droughts during dry seasons. They act like kidney of the earth. Now, Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve is on the brink of destruction, but the ones who feel the impact are Tasik Bukit Merah and Krian District. Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve is shrinking due to development. Forest Reserve was disgazetted to make way for oil palm plantation. From 5,000 acres of oil palm in 1989, the number had increased to more than 8,000 acres. Every time it rains, excess fertilizers, herbicides, and insecticides were washed to the river and ended up in Tasik Bukit Merah. Herbicides and insecticides kill fishes and other aquatic lives, while floating aquatic plants in Tasik Bukit Merah thrived from excess fertilizers. The destruction continues. On October 24, 2002, the state government degazetted another 1,400 hectares of Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve to develop a so-called modern national goat breeding center. A big portion of green and harmonious environment is now like a prairie. Generally, This national goat breeding project is supposed to be the supplier for nation's meat demand, but in reality, it's way out of target. A big number of sheds were left idle, some abandoned, and many more are waiting to collapse. Time will tell if this project is really sustainable or it's going to be another political scandal. But one thing for sure, 3,500 acres of lush greens is now gone. Ecosystem is disturbed and supply of water to Tasik Bukit Merah is polluted. Even Bukit Merah Lake Reserve was not spared. In 2001, these areas were pristine jungle, but now illegally cleared for oil palm plantation. Slowly but gradually, the size of Bukit Merah Lake Reserve is getting smaller and smaller. Jungle clearance was done openly, right under the nose of enforcement agencies. Bukit Merah is the oldest man-made lake. The dam was built in 1906 at the cost of $1.06 million with a height of 8.08 meters. In 1966, it was increased to 10.62 meters. In the 70s, with the introduction of modern agriculture where paddy was planted twice a year, the demand for water increased and the height of Bukit Merah Dam was increased to 11.28 meters or 33 feet. However, water level in the lake is always maintained at 28.5 feet. At this level, Tasik Bukit Merah is able to contain 83 million cubic meters of water. Based on the consumptions of around 2.5 million cubic meters per day, Tasik Bukit Merah is able to supply water for 33 days if there's no rain at all. The size of Tasik Bukit Merah is 35 square kilometers, but it is estimated that almost 40% of its lake is covered with floating aquatic plants. From 2006 to 2009, Drainage and Irrigation Department had spent around 13 million ringgit to clear these invasive plants. At the same time, Tasik Bukit Merah is getting shallower. Based on USM's study in 2008, it is estimated around 135 metric tons of silts and other sediments flowed into Tasik Bukit Merah every day. The study also found that around 10 to 15% of Tasik Bukit Merah's bed is covered with silts and sediments. Development of Bukit Merah Lake Town had caused further constraints to the management of Tasik Bukit Merah. Water level at Tasik Bukit Merah had to be maintained at 28.5 feet, while the floor of all chalet and resorts were built at 33 feet. To ensure safety to visitors and property of Bukit Merah Lake Town, critical level is set at 30 feet. In times of heavy downfall, the spillway's gate will automatically open when water level reaches 30 feet. Safety of Bukit Merah Lake Town Resort is the first priority in lake management. The new national double tracking project is being built across Tasik Bukit Merah and expected to be completed in mid-2013. This is another important safety aspect which has to be considered by drainage and irrigation department. The height of the track is the same as other buildings in Bukit Merah Lake Town at 33 feet, and critical level is 30 feet. Normal retention level is 28.5 feet and critical level is 30 feet. This means Tasik Bukit Merah has only 1.5 feet as buffer in case there is a heavy downpour. Tasik Bukit Merah has lost its role as buffer for water storage and flood mitigation, and it is now used just for the beautification of Bukit Merah Lake Town. Another constraint faced by the management of Tasik Bukit Merah is the emergence of new settlement on its reserve land. This was allowed for some political reasons, even though the access road to the village is just a few inches above water level. And when water level at Tasik Bukit Merah increased, access road to the village were cut off. These are problems faced by drainage and irrigation department when there's excess water. What will happen during dry season? Severe drought in June 2009 caused the lake to dry up. Water level was reduced to 20.25 feet, just a quarter feet before reaching minimum critical level of 20 feet. Water supply to Krian district was rationed, and this caused anger to residents. Even activities at Bukit Merah Lake Town were disrupted when Orang Utan Island was inaccessible to boats due to low water level. In November 2008, Krian district suffered a major flood, and in June 2009, they suffered severe drought. These extreme conditions proved that Tasik Bukit Merah had failed in its role to manage water, and all these were caused by deforestation and destruction of Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve. Water is the issue of all time. Too much or too little water will pose a problem to any political party. If Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve is not properly managed, it's not going to be just an environmental disaster, but political disaster as well. When it rains, water from highlands of Batu Kurau, Kubu Gajah and Selama flows towards Bukit Merah Lake. Pondok Tanjung acts as a filter and buffer before releasing it gradually to Tasik Bukit Merah. Tasik Bukit Merah will then release the water to Krian districts. Lembah Beria is another swamp forest used to absorb excess water from Pondok Tanjung, but now even Lembah Beria is slowly disappearing. A new township was developed on this swampy area, and it was a disaster. Out of 10 bungalows built, only one occupied. Almost all medium-cost houses suffered cracks and sinking. Property prices dropped and buyers are facing losses. Bukit Merah Dam has three spillways where the water is discharged. The North Spillway is used in emergency. Saddle Dam 2 is used to irrigate water to the main canal where arowana farms are situated. South Spillways is the main exit where water is discharged at 28 cubic meters per second.
Managing Tasik Bukit Merah is getting more challenging these days. Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve is no longer able to handle water during rainy seasons. Every time it rains, Tasik Bukit Merah couldn't handle the sudden surge of water due to all the constraints it is facing. Arowana farms require continuous supply of water, paddy fields and domestic consumptions are ever increasing.
In 2001, Professor Mashor from USM issued the first warning to the state government on the importance of conserving Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve. Ironically, the state de-gazetted 1,400 hectares of Pondok Tanjung Forest Reserve the following year for National Goat Project. Lembah Beria, which was supposed to be our last savior, had also been developed. Press statements and press conferences were made to remind those in power about the danger of deforestation. Letters to Menteri Besar were never answered.
Jumlah mangsa banjir di daerah Kerian berkurangan daripada 289 orang petang semalam kepada 251 orang hari ini. Jurucakap Bilik Gerakan Ibu Pejabat Polis Kontijen Perak berkata, mangsa banjir yang masih berada di dua pusat pemindahan adalah dari 11 kampung di daerah terbabit. Kesemua mangsa kini ditempatkan di pusat pemindahan itu di Sekolah Kebangsaan Bukit Merah dan Sekolah Kebangsaan Alor Fongsu. Mangsa banjir yang masih ditempatkan di pusat pemindahan itu adalah dari Kampung Matang Pasir, Kampung Tanjung Bugis, Kampung Parit Simpang 5, Batu 37 dan 38 Jalan Kereta Api, Kampung Parit Abu Hasan, Parit Haji Hasan Ban, Parit Mak Keling, Kampung Tebuk Panco, Kampung Parit Air Hitam dan Kampung Perlis katanya. Kawasan terbabit masih ditenggelami air sedalam 0.5 meter hingga 1 meter. Banjir melanda kawasan terbabit ekoran langkah melepaskan air dari empangan Bukit Merah yang berada di paras bahaya akibat hujan lebat sejak
minggu lalu. Masalah banjir yang paling serius berlaku di negeri Perak ialah di daerah Kerian. Dan ini menimbulkan masalah setiap tahun kepada masyarakat yang ada di sini. Kerajaan negeri amat simpati dengan keadaan mereka. Dan pada kali ini, untuk pengetahuan semua, keadaan yang berlaku ini agak luar biasa sedikit. Kebiasaannya setiap tahun kita akan membuat persiapan pada bulan 12, bulan 1. Tiba-tiba pada tahun ini dia berubah sedikit, iaitu berlaku pada bulan ini. Baru 3-4 hari ini hujan agak lebat dan telah pun melepasi garis yang kritikal dan berada dalam keadaan yang berbahaya. Dan saya sekali lagi mengharapkan agar Kerajaan Persekutuan dapat membantu Kerajaan Negeri Perak bagi mengatasi masalah di Lembah Kerian ini, kerana Lembah Kerian ini adalah merupakan kawasan tanah rata yang agak sukar untuk air itu mengalir keluar apabila berlakunya limpahan air ataupun banjir yang besar.
Kita akan membuat perancangan untuk menyelesaikan, dan malah Kerajaan Negeri telah pun menyediakan satu plan komprehensif untuk kita selesaikan masalah ini. Dan ini termasuklah dengan memohon kepada pihak Kerajaan Persekutuan. Anggaran awal kita adalah melebihi 300 juta lah untuk pelan keseluruhannya. Selain daripada itu juga kita mohon untuk kita buat kolam-kolam takungan dalam, sama ada dalam bentuk empangan yang baru mungkin, untuk bagi mengelakkan air mengalir.
Thank you.
district was flooded, but the course remained unattended. Everyone seems happy giving out aid. Everyone started giving solutions, spending millions without understanding the ecosystem. Millions of ringgit of public money is going to be spent on flood mitigation program, but only a few understand the real problem.